You know, I would say that it would be the benefit they get. It is not truly, it looks like it's the benefit you're giving to the other person, but the benefit and the gift is back to you. And that, as humans, that's part of, you know, our mission is to take care of one another and to share with one another. But some people just don't, they don't want to do it. You know, I have family members that absolutely think it's ridiculous to give to churches or, you know, and, but that's their, what they want to do. And, you know, sometimes I tell them I give it to them in their name. My one brother. But, you know, it's just that you can't make another person want to do something like that. You have to either show by your example or you do it in their name and whatever. So
just try it. Just to see how it, try and see how it feels. I mean, it's not going to hurt. Because when I did it, it didn't hurt. I just said, well, I'm going to keep giving till end of time.
I guess maybe to look around and see how blessed they are, and that, and maybe they need to think second again about giving from their heart to what it can do, what their contribution can do. Because to keep a church going, it takes quite a bit. But you know, you are where you are on your journey, and you do what you can, and whatever your heart tells you, you can do. I know probably our heart sometimes tells us we want to do more than we can do, but do what you can, and just keep in mind that we are Christ followers, and he has led us by example to care for others, and I think that means our church also.
Let's face it, this life, this world can be an ugly place at times. And, you know, the children are the ones who are the innocent victims, inevitably. And, you know, that to me is where you have to begin. And yes, there's other constituencies. Someone needs to take it upon themselves to help these folks out. And
so why not?
If your heart isn't big enough to see this, then we got bigger issues.
I think that it's not just about giving your money, but about giving your time and giving your talent. And that has been one thing that I think over, particularly with, that's a talent I have. I'm blessed that I can sing, and I love to sing, and it's something I enjoy sharing. And somebody that's very well organized and has that kind of a talent can be extremely helpful for doing all sorts of things in a church or any other organization. So it, you know, somebody that just is able to do something, somebody that likes to answer a phone, you know, I mean, all of those, they're small jobs, somebody has to do them, but they can become extremely important. You know, serving on a committee and being a part, putting your input, offering your input.
That's right.
So can be important when you're part of a group, an organization, a church, a mm-hmm. family.
Well, I think a lot of it is a reflection on what, first of all, what does the church mean to you? What does the church mean to you? What does this church mean to you? And what would you do if the church wasn't here? Right? And that's not a threat. It's not like, if you don't get it, we're going to go away. You know, I mean, that's not what it means. But I mean, even though in some ways that's true, it's more giving from the heart. And so being able to connect yourself to the church and understand that you have something to contribute, whether it's money or time, that we're all here together, and it takes all of us, you know, to come together. And I don't care whether it's a dollar, whether it's a quarter, whether it's $2, you know, just the act of giving on a regular basis, you know, you realize that's meaningful and it's fulfilling. And you know, you also realize that you give a dollar, you're thinking, oh, well, maybe I could give $2, or maybe I can get $1.50 or whatever. And you give what your comfort level is, but it is rewarding. It really is rewarding.
We historically there's been this sense of 10% being a tithe and the right amount. I used to think that way. Again, that gets back to being brought up in a very conservative household and thinking very, very strictly along those lines. And I don't think 10% is the answer. I don't know what the answer is for you, or sometimes I don't even know what the answer is for us, and it does vary a little. You know, I think 10% is sort of it's a nice figure. It's as good as any figure, but I think numbers should speak to you. And whatever number speaks to you, that's the right number. Maybe it's 1%, maybe it's 20%. Maybe it's what you can afford right now. But I think you need to think about all that, and just, you need to give a little, whatever that means, or you need to give a lot, depending on your circumstances. I mean, there's so many things to think about. But I think the most important thing is to give something. And I know you hear a lot these, you know, it's not important how much you give. It's important that you give. And that's sort of a cliche. And I realize I'm falling into that, but I really do believe it's true. I think the idea is that you need to give something back. So the other thing I would say to a person in that mindset is, yeah, don't get hung up on the figure. And if you only have a dollar in your pocket that week, then fine, put the dollar in. And don't worry about it, don't fret over it, and think more methodically about, you know, what the number should be. Don't feel guilty if you're only giving 7% when the goal might be 10. Rejoice if you're giving 15. But don't get hung up all that. Give the amount that feels right to you and your immediate family, whatever that is, whoever that is.